to a recent deal, Securicor can now offer a complete worldwide distribution service. The deal included the acquisition of a highly advanced computerized labeling system and resulted in the equivalent of 3 years' growth overnight. A major competitor is now out of the marketplace. What exactly was that deal? This is the FedEx story. The parcels business in the UK has boomed in the past 15 years. And although Securicor has enjoyed a successful position in the domestic market, it was experiencing problems with its European operations. Other overseas companies were also facing similar problems in Europe, many losing a lot of money, and a number of them began to form partnerships. One of those companies competing for the UK domestic market was in particular trouble.
In order to offer a guaranteed service, the length and breadth of the UK, and to guarantee delivery, you need a vast resource of branches. For example, we have in Securicor Omega Express 126 branches backed up with 28 Pony Express locations. We employ 7,000 staff and have a fleet of vehicles in excess of 3,500. Now, in order to maintain that kind of resource, it's necessary to have a critical mass of packages at the right price. And the problem FedEx faced in the UK is that there's too many companies chasing too little parcels.
How did the acquisition come about?
Well, it was fairly obvious to those in the industry that Federal Express, like a number of companies, were having problems in developing Europe. We were both extremely successful in our own home markets, and therefore it seemed to make sense to me that the two parties should get together to explore possible opportunities. During October of 91, I telephoned Federal Express's headquarters in Memphis to request a meeting with the chief executive officer, and the rest is now history.
What exactly did the deal consist of?
On the 5th of May 1992, we acquired the domestic customer base of Federal Express in the UK. We employed 500 of their staff and took on 250 of their vehicles. At the same time, we purchased 477 Powership units, now known as Trans-IT.
Why was the deal so favourable to Securicor?
Well, apart from the fact that overnight, for the sum of 7.4 million, we acquired somewhere in the region of £26 million worth of business, we also became the sole carrier for Federal Express's intercontinental business within the UK but outside the M25. That therefore not only added to our market share, increasing the critical mass I referred to earlier, but it also brought us into line and a partner with one of the world's greatest names within the industry.
Just what sort of impact has the deal had on the Securicor workforce and its resources?
Part of the purchase agreement with Federal Express was that we would buy 250 of their vehicles. In fact, we bought three main types of vehicles. First, we bought quite a number of tractor and trailer units, and these went immediately into use in the fleet, and they'll be put into Omega colours over the coming months. The great benefit of buying these vehicles is that we now won't have to buy any replacement tractor or trailer units until October 1993. And when you consider that a new tractor and trailer unit costs approximately £50,000, that's quite a saving. Second kind of vehicle we bought was some 3.5-ton Sherpa vans. The reason we bought these was that under the price formula in the purchase agreement, they were a particularly attractive buy. They're an average of 18 months old, they'll go into use in the fleet, and they'll again all be re-liveried into Omega colours. Finally, we bought a number of Mercedes 3.5-ton vans. These are older vehicles, so we won't re-livery them into Omega colours, but they'll be run in their Federal Express livery for the coming 12 months.
Looking ahead, how do you see Securicor and Federal Express working together?
I see some incredible opportunities with the network that Securicor have got domestically. There are incredible advantages for Federal Express to enhance their services, and vice versa, I see with the worldwide global network that Federal Express have got, that there are other future opportunities there to build and strengthen our relationship globally as well.
How has your customer reacted to the integration with Securicor?
But we've been very pleasantly surprised. Customers have supported us, they've stayed with us, and our volumes have stabilised, and we're looking for future growth.
How will the workforce benefit from this deal, and just how much extra work was created?
We should understand the position over the last couple of years when we've seen, particularly in the parcels industry, major players dropping out, significant numbers of job reductions and redundancies. And we made this important acquisition, as far as we're concerned, to not only remove from the marketplace a major competitor, but secure the long-term future of our own employees. By October, when traditionally we see the build-up for Christmas, I would anticipate we'll see something like 15 to 20% more parcels coming into the system. That would mean certainly in excess of 1.5 million parcels per week.
One of the most exciting aspects of the deal was the acquisition of the highly advanced computerised labelling system, TransIT.
Basically, the TransIT system is a PC-based system which is installed in the customer's premises, and it produces all the documentation automatically associated with dispatching a parcel. To us, it's important because it actually produces a routing code on the parcel label, which enables our sorter loaders to automatically sort the parcel to the correct delivery branch. For the customer, it actually saves them a lot of time and effort.
The TransIT system has actually reduced our packing staff by 50%. It's completely speeded the operation up by passing it all onto one controller, who then produces the labels and the consignment notes.
It's actually a very, very important piece in the Sparks jigsaw, which is now nearing completion. And it gives the customer the opportunity to interface with us in the most up-to-date technological way. Well, the staff in our branches and terminals are now seeing a new label in the system, which gives them all the information that they need to be able to deliver the parcels on time.
So TransIT is without doubt a vital part of the acquisition and has strengthened Securicor's already highly competitive position in the market. But of course, it isn't just the arrival of new technology and the acquiring of an already well-established customer base that has made this deal such a success.
The staff were both surprised and probably shocked that Securicor Omega Express, who had been the subject to a number of rumours over the last 12 months that either Federal Express or UPS or TNT or somebody was going to be purchasing us, that we became the predator and not the victim. The staff, they rose to the challenge, as they always do. Traditionally, Securicor can rise to a challenge, and putting 30 to 40,000 parcels into the system was some challenge. My part was easy, 250 vehicles, 500 people, that'll do the job. But when they see those parcels, they have to move them, and they did, and I'm very proud of the way they did, and I know that everybody else is proud that they achieved that. I thank them.
It's quite clear that this deal will have a positive impact on the staff. It also means that we have a greater market share and that Securicor Omega Express is the largest undisputed private parcels carrier in the UK, offering a global network. What is also clear is that this is a story of teamwork, where staff at all levels have come together to build a solid foundation on which to secure an exciting road ahead.
Taffs Well was first commissioned in 1979, and it was a unit that was capable of handling the amount of traffic then, and it did last as well until the middle 80s when we acquired an additional unit. That then again expended itself by the early 90s, and it was decided in the latter part of the 90s to raise a paper asking to a replacement building be provided that would cope with a modern parcels service.
At the present moment, we're in a split operation system, with the two buildings. So we have to move from building one, reload into cage, etc., move them across the road into building two.
In close conjunction with the property department, our brief was to design a building around a conveyor system that would eliminate these problems, greatly improve the working conditions, and cater for growth.
Well, this has a special significance to the property department because it marks our return after many years to property development.
The growth in South Wales for Omega Parcels has been phenomenal. And since the conception of Nantgarw, Taffs Well alone has seen an 18% increase in parcel delivery, which represents an additional 1,000 items plus a day. And we anticipate we will see between a 7 and 10% growth annualising in the future.
Items like consignment for schools, which require storage due to school holidays, can be stored on a mezzanine, purpose-built mezzanine floor. These facilities, allied to parking facilities for the staff vehicles outside of the secured area and transport servicing facilities on site, provide a modern, efficient working environment that will take us through the 90s and into the future.
And the latest news on that story is that Nantgarw went live on the 1st of November. And now for vehicles. Alan Hines, Managing Director of Securicor Vehicle Services, took time to tell us about the latest addition to the parcels fleet.
Earlier this year, Richard Benson approached Securicor Vehicle Services with a view to introducing a high roof transit van to the fleet. The first of these have recently gone into use, and we have one of them here. As you can see, the vehicle is a standard transit van, except that the roof is raised by over a foot. That gives us two big advantages. First, it allows a larger volume of parcels to be loaded, so more can be carried and it's more cost effective. Second, the height inside is enough for a 6-foot man to stand upright, so the vehicle provides a better and more comfortable working environment. If all goes well and the vehicle does what we expect of it on the road, all new transits from now on will be with the higher roof. That means we'll be buying over 400 of them across the coming 12 months, and they should soon be appearing right across the country.
Pony Express and Auto Parts Express have joined to create Securicor Pony Express, a same day and next day courier operation. It will operate from 28 locations across the UK mainland, with headquarters based in Worthing. The merger was announced by Securicor Pony Express Managing Director Mark Smith, who said, "The new company will provide us with greater capability and better representation in the small business market. We have introduced one-stop shopping to the small business user."
I think this is an extremely hard-working terminal. When a new job starts like FedEx, we cope with that very well. We obviously have a Christmas rush coming up. That coupled with FedEx this year is going to be particularly bad. The parcel level is going to be particularly heavy, but I know we'll cope. I don't believe in starting at 9 o'clock. It's far too late to put any problems that have arisen right at 9 o'clock. And I've always been a great believer in starting early. I normally start every day before half past six. I go round the different departments in which I think is the order of importance. I therefore visit the overnight terminal first to make sure they're clear, the nights have completed, that the FedEx parcels have moved. I then move on to the freight building, make sure everything's fine there, then down to the local section to make sure the drivers have attended, that the runs are covered, etc. And everything's running smoothly.
My name is Fred Lee. I've been with Securicor since 1973. Because I've been here 20 years and been driving most of the time, they presume I've done approximately a million miles, yes, which I suppose you have, you know. But I wouldn't like to count them. When you're out doing collections, then yes, you are the face of Securicor, I suppose, and that's why they sort of put us in this sort of uniform and not a sort of a lorry driver's t-shirt and jeans, to keep an image up, I suppose, which is good. I like the image.
I'm Sam Hepburn. I'm the assistant terminal manager here. Coming at 8 o'clock, and then I open up the mail, and then I deal with any problems that may come through. Then I pass the invoices, do the monthly budget, help Alan with the yearly budget.
Mr. H. Parker, what shift does he work on?
10 till 7.
I think that the night workers in terminals particularly are unsung heroes of Securicor, the volumes they handle.
Half past nine on a Wednesday night, London Colney Terminal. Things aren't going so bad. Things are buzzing. We're getting there. The trunks are coming in as normal. We've got one problem. Milton Keynes branch has had a breakdown, but we should be able to get that back tonight and hopefully have another good night.
Well, this work is turned round on a regular basis at the correct time, and the trunks run very smoothly, and the staff are proud of what they achieve, and so am I.
In the Esso British Touring Car Championship, our driver Will Hoyce scored 149 points and came second. In the Manufacturers' Championships, Toyota came in second with 134 points, and as for the teams, the Securicor ICS Toyota came in second place, this time with a score of 277. Well done, and better luck next year. In the next issue, there'll be a profile of Signline, a feature on Securicor Pony Express, and news of Network Europe. We'll also be on the road again. I hope you've enjoyed Amiga News. If you have any items for our next issue, please drop a line to me, Maria Finnis at Securicor TV, Richmond. See you in the new year.